Hello and namaste everyone, I'm Pratima and welcome to yet another laptop review video. Last week we reviewed the Asus ZenBook Flip 13, which was a great 2-in-1 OLED powered ultrabook. And today I have the Yoga 7i, which is Lenovo's 2-in-1 laptop. It has the latest 11th gen Tiger Lake CPU, 8GB of RAM and 256GB of SSD. This particular model retails for around $810 and is priced similarly here in Nepal at 110,000 rupees. Anyways, before going on with the review, a massive shout out to G2 Deal for sponsoring this video. It happens to most of us that we ignore the activate Windows message on our desktop because Windows key is so darn expensive, right? But worry not, because G2 Deal has got you covered. This site offers you the chance to buy a CD key of Windows 10 Professional at a cheap price. To activate your Windows, simply copy the activation code that you have purchased and paste it in the Activate Windows option of the system settings. Also, while purchasing Windows 10, you can enter the special promo code Q18 in the checkout section and get an extra 18% discount on the already slashed prices. So design-wise, the Yoga 7i is one well-built laptop. It has an all-metal aluminium build quality, so it looks premium and professional enough to blend into corporate settings. It is available in either slate gray or dark moss finish, so it's fair to say that both color options ooze premium aesthetics. But since it's a big 15.6 inches machine, you will have to use both your hands to open up the laptop. It weighs 1.9 kg, so it's not the lightest convertible laptop you can buy, but still it's not as heavy as those chunky gaming laptops. Anyway, the 360-degree hinge is pretty solid and lets you seamlessly shape the device into different form factors depending upon your need. In terms of cooling mechanism, the Yoga 7i gets a single fan, which is to be expected from such a device. There's the standard air intake vents at the bottom, while the exhaust is sandwiched in the hinge itself. Security-wise, the Windows Hello-compliant fingerprint sensor on the keyboard deck is quite fast and accurate. When it comes to port selection, I feel like Lenovo has made an unnecessary compromise here by not including a multimedia card reader and an RJ45 port. Besides this, it is quite decent with two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, two Thunderbolt 4 compatible USB Type-C ports, and a 3.5mm mic/headphone jack combo. Alright, getting to the display side of things, I have the 15.6 inches variant with full HD LCD screen. But if you are looking for a more compact device, a 14-inch variant also exists. Regardless, even the 15.6 inches model is available in two screen options. One has 250 nits of brightness and covers 45% NTSC color space, whereas a superior Dolby Vision compliant alternative boasts 500 nits of brightness and 100% sRGB color gamut. But the former is what I have with me right now. As expected, this screen is far from ideal for outdoor usage as it simply cannot get bright enough. Also, I find its brightness levels to be slightly insufficient. Adaptive brightness is also kind of an issue here as the abrupt and broad variation in the illumination levels could be a literal eyesore. This glossy panel also complicates things when you're in a room with plenty light reflecting objects. Other than this, things are pretty much what you would expect from an LCD laptop display. The viewing angles are fine, but I did notice slight screen bleeding issues on the lower edge of the display. The colors obviously don't pop out as much, and in its default setting, I find the screen to be leaning on the bluish hint a bit more. On the other hand, the touch response of this display is fantastic, and be it playing games or simply browsing through the web, the Lenovo Yoga 7i screen is a delight to use. Moreover, it also supports stylus input, although the company does not provide the supported Lenovo digital pen inside the box. Okay, now let's talk about the keyboard, and frankly speaking, these concave design keys weirded me out at first and I struggled to type efficiently on it, but thankfully I got used to it after a couple of days. The keys are well spaced out but ultimately feel a little cheap. The keyboard deck does not flex much either, although there's a considerable flex on the central position of the chassis. Additionally, the keys feel a little mushy as well. The key travel distance is pretty good though, and I did not experience any sort of mistypes under my usage. It is also backlit with two levels to choose from. Overall, it's a pretty average keyboard. Likewise, the Yoga 7i's trackpad is nothing special either. It is a glass-covered touchpad, but this non-centric layout still does not sit right with me as I often tend to mistake the right key with the left one even to this day. The integrated left-right keys do click well, but I wish they were a little quieter. Besides, the multi-finger gestures, including pinch to zoom, work just fine here. Okay, coming to the webcam, Lenovo has included an industry standard 720p HD camera in here. It isn't Windows Hello compliant, but it's still got a dedicated privacy shutter. There's a tiny switch at the top of the display that you can slide to keep the camera from prying eyes.
Okay, about the quality of the webcam itself, it looks pretty good as you can see. As expected, the subject looks a little bit soft, but considering what passes for a webcam in laptops these days, I have no complaints about this one. The audio pickup from the dual array microphone is not all that bad either.
Moving on, Lenovo is also targeting this laptop for content consumption demographics with its audio setup. This Dolby Atmos certified front-firing speaker system gets pretty loud, although as expected, it lags behind in terms of details as compared to a standalone speaker. Yet, it's miles better in contrast to practically every other laptop that I've used so far. Okay, finally, let's get into the performance side of things. Powering this laptop is the latest Intel Tiger Lake U processor. You can choose between an i5 or i7 CPU, and the former is what's inside our unit. This has been coupled with 8GB of DDR4 RAM running at 3200MHz and 256GB of M.2 SSD storage. Thankfully, the SSD is upgradable here, but unfortunately, the RAM has been soldered onto the motherboard. So if you're into multitasking or simply run heavy apps, I suggest you go with the 16GB option. That's because this 8GB variant that I have with me has disappointed me in that regard. First off, its memory management is pretty miserable when having multiple tabs open. My prime time usage mostly consists of editing a photo or two in Adobe Photoshop alongside editing Word documents while browsing Chrome with about 5 to 6 tabs open. On multiple occasions, the Chrome tab would require a reload after keeping it idle for a while. Looking at the memory usage chart in the task manager, I often notice that this would take up about 86% of the available RAM space. But bringing games into the mix is where this laptop gives up. I tried to play Valorant with a couple of Chrome tabs open in the background, and in more than one instance, I got a "your computer is running low on memory" error, which eventually evolved into a blue screen. Furthermore, Yoga 7i's SSD's read and write speeds are disappointing too, especially the write speeds. Anyway, the Yoga 7i does not get a discrete GPU as well, but as we know by now, the integrated Iris Xe graphics is pretty commendable. As a result, you can even play a couple of esports titles in limited settings. At high graphics settings with 2x MSAA, I got 35 to 38 FPS in Valorant, while the FPS count jumped to 48 FPS under medium settings. For optimal gameplay, dialing down the graphics to low with everything else turned off got me about 71 FPS on average. Similarly, CSGO gives a playable 58 FPS under low video settings with MSAA and FXAA turned off. However, this by no means is a gaming laptop. After about 5 minutes of gaming or so, the top left area of the keyboard gets warm, but that's tolerable, I guess. There are also a couple of fan profiles to choose from in the Lenovo Vantage toolkit. For the best gameplay experience, the extreme performance profile is what you'd want to use. Similarly, you can download device drivers and control various system settings via this handy software. I also like its toolbar shortcut that displays battery level in percentage and holds shortcuts like cooling modes, camera settings, mic settings, etc. Now moving on to the battery, the Lenovo Yoga 7i features a 71 watt hour battery with which I managed to get around 9 to 9.5 hours of screen on time. So I am pretty satisfied with its battery performance. On the charging front, Lenovo ships a 65 watt hour AC adapter inside the box that takes about 1 hour and 50 minutes to fully juice up this laptop. Either USB-C ports on the left is power delivery compliant, so you can even use a USB PD charger to charge this device. Moreover, you can enable the rapid charge feature from the toolkit, which promises 3 hours of runtime with just 15 minutes of power plugged in. All in all, I would say that the Lenovo Yoga 7i is an okay-ish 2-in-1 laptop. And I really hope that Lenovo sends an update to fix the memory management issue in the coming days. And if you are really thinking of getting one of these, my suggestion would be get the 16GB RAM variant instead. Other than that, I particularly don't have any issues with the Yoga 7i. It has a fairly nice visual aesthetics complemented by a terrific speaker system, decent battery life, and a privacy shutter laden webcam. So yeah, that was my take on the Lenovo Yoga 7i 2-in-1 laptop. Lately, I've been thinking of doing more and more laptop reviews. So if you guys have any suggestions on what laptop I should review next, do let me know in the comments. And also do not forget to subscribe to us and hit that bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of our future content. Saying this, it's me, Pratima, signing off. See you in the next video.